Roughly 1.5 million people filed for unemployment benefits last week. That marks the 14th straight week that filings remained above 1 million. Meanwhile, the number of people receiving those unemployment benefits did decline from the previous week, though we are still talking about roughly 19.5 million people who are still receiving those claims. Let's bring in Ed Stringham. He's a president at American Institute for Economic Research. He's also a professor at Trinity College. And it's good to talk to you. You know, it seems like we've got sort of every week some positive and some negative news. You know, on the one hand, we're seeing, you know, sort of the job market slowly bounce back. We are seeing an uptick from the lows that we saw back in April. And yet you still look at the number today. I mean, 1.48 million Americans filing for unemployment claims. What does that suggest in terms of where we are in the path to recovery?
So it's been bad, and things have taken longer to get back to normal than a lot of people predicted. So many businesses can stay closed for 2 weeks, but when it starts getting towards 3 months, you start seeing a lot of these big traditional companies closing, and especially that's been the case for small businesses. So the economy's been hit, and we see the jobs numbers reflecting that. Now, there's fewer people filing for new unemployment claims than a couple months ago, so that, I guess, could leave room for optimism, but there's still a lot of people who want to and need to get back to work.
We also did get the GDP print today unchanged. We're talking about a 5% contraction in the first quarter. Economists have always said that this current quarter, the second quarter, is going to be the worst. And Ed, you've pointed out in your notes what the Atlanta Fed has said, a contraction of anywhere from 45 to 55%. When you look at what's happening right now with the case counts and some of the states rolling back their reopening process, how big of a hit is this likely to have on the recovery process, even if businesses aren't forced to close?
Well, I mean, just to think about that number that from the Atlanta Federal Reserve is a 50% decrease in growth. It's just tremendously harmful for the economy that a lot of people overlooked that. Now, I would say one room for optimism is if you look at death rates, those are going down a lot. Number of deaths are also going down a lot. We're increasing testing a huge amount, and I think that is understandable that we're seeing more people who are being found testing positive. But in terms of hospitals not being overrun and death rates going way down, I think that is room for optimism. I think a lot of businesses think it's safe and they want to get back to work.
But in terms of the impact to the economy, I mean, I'm curious what you think about how this is likely to affect sentiment. The fact that it's not really business closures or nothing. You know, there's sort of this in-between where businesses are trying to operate through the phase two or phase three, wherever their cities are right now. But consumers just don't feel comfortable going out because there is still the big uncertainty around how big of a hold or how controlled, contained the virus is right now.
I think that's right. In certain industries, such as, you know, the cruise ship industry, obviously, I feel the worst for them, or that airline industry. I think a lot of people do not feel safe. But if you do look at polls of people, would you feel comfortable going to your favorite restaurant? The majority of people actually will say yes. And it's interesting the way the polling is conducted. If it says your favorite restaurant, the percentage increases. So I think, you know, there's going to be certain people wary, but at least here in New York, there's I can report that there's more and more people out on the streets every day and out going out to the restaurants as well.
And finally, Ed, you know, we're already starting to see the fallout on the corporate front. We've obviously had a number of retailers file for bankruptcy. Today, Macy's coming out saying it's going to be cutting 3% of its workforce, 3,900 jobs. How far are we from realizing the full extent of this? I mean, if you look at something like the cuts that we saw today, is this just the tip of the iceberg?
I mean, it could be. Mm-hmm. If the businesses have to stay closed longer, yes. Macy's has been on a slow decline over the last few years, but really the last few months since the lockdown, they're basically lost about 80% of their stock prices. So it's definitely hitting them really hard. And there's certain companies, you know, we've seen them, some of the big named famous companies, that it just puts them over the edge. Any company can handle a one day off, but 100 days off, it starts getting really difficult, even for the big established corporations.
Ed Stringham, the president at American Institute for Economic Research. Appreciate your insight today.
Thank you so much.